I'm gonna take an elevator trip up to the top of this very, very tall building. And in the time it takes for the elevator to go up to the top and back down, I'm gonna get a physicist to explain the beginning of the universe to me. Sounds easy, right? Okay, so I learned a bit about the Big Bang in high school, and what I kind of know is that the universe started from a single point, and then there was a big explosion, and everything moved away from each other, and there was a lot of heat and pressure, and then that formed planets, and the universe is expanding, but I want to know what I've gotten wrong.
That's really good so far. I guess one thing I'll correct you on is just that it wasn't really an explosion in the sense of, you know, there's a big darkness and the universe is like going out into it. That darkness doesn't exist. The universe is everything. So it's more of an expansion than an explosion. And it was really hot and dense, as you said. And then as the universe cooled, indeed, we did form protons and neutrons, hydrogen, and then they would fuse together to form helium. And then we have the rest of the planets forming
but
later.
What was before? How did we get the stuff to expand?
We don't know is the short answer. Using our theories, general relativity and particle physics, we can wind the clock back to the very beginning, about 10 to the minus 35 seconds after the Big Bang, and we can understand pretty much that entire journey right down to that point. And then beyond that, we really don't know. That's where we hit the singularity.
What's a singularity?
Well, that's a point of infinite pressure and density, and at that point, we're at the top.
We're halfway through. You have one ride down to explain the entire beginning of the universe to me. Do you think you can do it?
I'll try.
All right, singularity.
At the singularity, we've got a point where we just don't know the physics anymore. We've got black holes and the star of the universe are points where we just don't have the physics yet to understand what's going on.
But it's obviously got to be like a huge human question, like what came before? Do we even have a way of starting to know?
Yeah, we can make little extensions to our theories that might give us hints as to what...
So like extensions to things we already know are true?
Right.
Right.
And so then you can sort of design problems where you think, okay, well maybe the universe is a membrane or it's formed by like membranes colliding, or you might think about big crunches.
What's the big crunch?
Well, some people think that we might be heading towards a point where the universe gets back to being a singularity.
And then could go again.
And so maybe we may not be the first one of those cycles. It could happen again and again and again. But until we really understand our own universe, we won't be able to test those ideas.
So we're just guessing?
Well, we're making...
Educated guesses! Well, I guess that's the best we can do right now.
For now.
Bye!
Bye!
Wait, no, but what do we base those theories on? Because you can't just speculate. You can't just go out there speculating.
That's more or less what it is.
As a scientist, you're not allowed. You have to have it based on something, right?
Yeah, so it's a speculation based on things which small extensions to our laws might allow. Yeah, so we don't have like a theory of everything. So we say, oh, well, maybe with this small addition, if we just add this one extra ingredient, then maybe we can have this process going on. An expansion process, a recollapse process, multiple universes, multiverses. Multiverses.
What was really interesting to me in that conversation was kind of challenging all of these things that I'd heard a lot of things about before, like the Big Bang and what came before the Big Bang, and really making it tangible, because I didn't realize, but I definitely had the assumption that the darkness was something that the universe was exploding into, but it's not. There was nothing there before. And I know that sounds silly, but it's just assumed knowledge. And then to hear how scientists are kind of working with what we already know to figure out what we don't is actually really exciting, because I didn't know that that's how they did it. I didn't know that they are using theories that they can already prove and then making a little change to it and seeing if that works. And hearing that makes me feel like we might actually not be that far off knowing what came before the Big Bang, what came before the singularity. It's just, what came before, we might know. Hey, so if you enjoyed watching me have my mind blown about the beginning of the universe, then stay tuned, because we are gonna have more videos for you. We had a lot of fun filming this elevator pitch. We actually had to do it a couple times because a guy in a suit kept getting into the lift and it just kept distracting us, especially Julian.
that the universe was static and infinite and just kept going.
If you have a topic that you'd like to see us tackle, then you can leave it in the comments below. Please do, because I cannot keep coming up with these ideas myself. You can also hit the subscribe button and get updates as to what we are up to. But until then, I'll see you next time.